So in the previous class, we discussed about introduction to fins. Fins are nothing but protrusions from the base, which will enhance the heat transfer rate by increasing the surface area to convection. And also we discussed about types of fins. Okay, annular fin as well as longitudinal fins or spines, and also some applications of fins. After that, we have derived a differential equation for a rectangular cross section. Governing differential equation for a rectangular cross section fin, that is theta is equal to c1 cos hyperbolic mx plus c2 sin hyperbolic mx. Hyperbolic functions there. Then we discussed about case number one, that is infinitely long fin. Okay, that at a temperature distribution along the length of the fin, as well as we have found out the heat transfer rate for an infinitely long fin. Okay, so in today's class, we'll take case number two. That is a fin with insulated end. So here I have shown the insulated fin with temperature profile also. Okay, so this is the base temperature, that is T naught. H and TA represents convective heat transfer coefficient as well as ambient temperature of the surrounding fluid. Okay, this is the length of the fin L. Okay, so TA represents ambient temperature. Okay, this is the temperature profile. You can see at the interface of fin and base surface, temperature will be T naught, and the temperature is going to decrease gradually with the increase in length. Okay, so since this is a fin with the insulated end, okay, actually what it means insulated end is the temperature at the end will be negligible. We can take it. Okay, it is not exactly insulated. It means that the heat transfer from the tip of the fin is very, very small when compared to heat transfer from the surface of the fin. Okay, so you can assume like this for an insulated fin. So the heat transfer from this fin is zero, from this end of the fin. Okay, heat transfer from this end of the fin is zero, almost zero when compared to heat transfer from the surface of this fin. Now we'll try to obtain the temperature distribution as well as heat transfer rate for this fin by applying boundary conditions. So first boundary condition, you know, at x is equal to 0, theta will be theta naught. What is theta? Theta is nothing but T minus TA. Okay, T represents temperature at any point. Since it is x is equal to 0, okay, that means starting point of the fin, the temperature will be T naught. Okay, so T naught minus TA is the temperature difference at x is equal to 0, and at x is equal to L, the temperature gradients at x equal to L, temperature, that is d theta by dx, will be 0. Okay, this is very, very important. Okay, so at x equal to L, temperature gradients are negligible at the tip of the fin, if for the fin tip with insulated end. If we are going to apply these two boundary conditions for equation number 3, you know what is equation number 3? Theta is equal to c1 cos hyperbolic mx plus c2 sin hyperbolic mx. That equation you have to remember. So I am not going to show that equation. You know already what is equation 3. It is nothing but theta is equal to c1 cos hyperbolic mx plus c2 sin hyperbolic m into x. Correct? So theta will, if you apply the first boundary condition, what will be theta? Theta is nothing but theta naught. Okay, theta will become theta naught is equal to C1 cos hyperbolic m into x and x jagdali 0. We have put 0 in place of x plus C2 sin hyperbolic m into x again. X is 0. Okay, this value will become 0 now because sin hyperbolic 0 is 0. 0 multiplied by anything is 0 and cos hyperbolic m into 0 is 0. Cos hyperbolic 0 will be 1. So C1 will be equal to theta naught. That let it that let it be equation number 9. Okay, then equation 3, that is theta equal to C1 cos hyperbolic mx plus C2 sin hyperbolic mx. That equation will become theta will be, you know, C1 equation 3 nali C1 idaili, there is C1. Okay, for C1 I am going to put theta naught cos hyperbolic mx plus C2 sin hyperbolic mx. And I am going to differentiate this equation with respect to x. What you are going to get d theta by dx is equal to theta naught. If you differentiate this cos hyperbolic mx, it will be m times sin hyperbolic mx plus C2. Again, differentiation of this sin hyperbolic mx will be m times cos hyperbolic mx. Understood? Okay. D theta by dx. Okay. So using second boundary condition, what is second boundary condition? At x equal to L, d theta by dx will be 0. I am going to use this second boundary condition for this equation. That is, you have got now d theta by dx is equal to this. I am going to apply the second boundary condition. D theta by dx is actually what? 0 at x equal to L. Theta naught m sin hyperbolic m into x idaili, x jagdali, we are putting L. Plus C2 m cos hyperbolic m into x is there. Instead of x, we are going to put L. Understood? Okay. So, for this equation, I applied the second boundary condition. Okay. So, you have got this. Next, I have simplified for C2. What is C2? Constant C2 will be, you know, here also m, m gets cancelled. C2 will be minus theta naught. Okay, you take theta naught into sin hyperbolic ml to the left hand side, it will become minus sin hyperbolic ml divided by cos hyperbolic ml. Ili m already cancel again here. I have told you this m and this m is going to get cancelled if you divide by m. Okay, and you take this term, that is theta naught sin hyperbolic ml to the left hand side, minus theta naught sin hyperbolic ml divided by cos hyperbolic ml. It will become sin by cos. It is nothing but tan hyperbolic ml minus theta naught. I have directly written this equation. So you have got C2. That is equation number 10. Now you are going to apply C1 and C2. You are going to use C1 and C2 in equation number 3. So we get, so theta, first term is theta is equal to C1 cos hyperbolic ms. What is C1? Theta naught. Theta naught cos hyperbolic mx minus C2 sin hyperbolic mx. What is C2? Minus theta naught tan hyperbolic ml into sin hyperbolic mx. Understood, no? So you have used C1 and C2 in equation number 3. What is equation number 3? Theta is equal to C1 cos hyperbolic mx plus C2 sin hyperbolic mx. For C1 I have put theta naught and for C2 I have put minus theta naught tan hyperbolic mx. Understood? So you have got this equation. Theta by theta naught will be cos hyperbolic mx, okay, minus tan hyperbolic ml into sin hyperbolic mx. Okay, theta naught is common, no, both the sides. I have taken theta naught outside the, okay, outside you can take, and you can take it to the left hand side, it will become theta by theta naught. What is theta? Theta is nothing but temperature at any distance x minus ta divided by t naught minus ta, which is equal to cos hyperbolic mx minus sin hyperbolic. Okay, there is a tan hyperbolic ml is here, I have written for tan hyperbolic ml as sine by cos hyperbolics. Sine hyperbolic ml by cos hyperbolic ml. That is what I have written. Sine hyperbolic ml by cos hyperbolic ml. Okay, these are completely mathematics. Right. So Tx minus Ta by T naught minus Ta is equal to take cos hyperbolic ml as the LCM. What you are going to get? Cos hyperbolic ml. Okay. Here cos hyperbolic mx is there. So cos hyperbolic ml minus sine hyperbolic ml into sine hyperbolic mx. Okay. So left hand side I have written as it is, that is equal to, okay, this will be, okay, if you simplify this, this will be cos hyperbolic m into L minus x. That is from hyperbolic functions. Okay. This numerator will be cos hyperbolic m into L minus x divided by cos hyperbolic m. This equation gives temperature distribution in an insulated fin of uniform section along the length. Okay. So first you have got temperature distribution. Next we'll find out the heat transfer rate. Okay, we know that Q is equal to minus KAC d theta by dx at x equal to 0. So already you have got equation number 9, that is this equation 9. We are going, okay, this equation, we let us try to differentiate with respect to x. What you are going to get? D theta by dx. Okay, you know heat transfer rate will be obtained using this equation, no? Minus KAC d theta by dx at x equal to 0. Why we have taken x equal to 0? Because whatever the heat that has been entering into the fin, the same heat will be leaving by convection, through convection. So differentiating equation 9, and also we are going to put x equal to 0. What you are going to get? Differentiate this equation number 9. Okay, it is nothing but theta naught, okay, d theta by dx, okay, theta naught into cos hyperbolic mx. Differentiate, if you differentiate, it will become m into sine hyperbolic mx, okay, minus theta naught tan hyperbolic ml is constant, right? Differentiation of sine hyperbolic mx will be m into cos hyperbolic mx. Okay, so instead of x we have put 0, mx in the cos hyperbolic mx, x for x place we have put 0. Understood? Now we have differentiated equation number 9. If you differentiate this, theta naught into m into sine hyperbolic mx, theta naught m into sine hyperbolic mx, okay, x 0. Okay, similarly this term is constant, and if you differentiate sine, it will become cos of m into cos hyperbolic m into x. Instead of x we have put 0 here, right? This term will become 0 because sine hyperbolic of anything 0 is 0. So remaining is minus theta naught m into tan hyperbolic ml. So q will be k times, okay, q will be, that is equal, this equation q will be minus k times ac. So you have got d theta by dx, no, minus theta naught m into tan hyperbolic ml. So there is a minus sign here also, minus sign, minus into minus, plus k times ac. What is d theta by dx? It is theta naught m into tan hyperbolic ml. So KAC m into theta naught tan hyperbolic ml. Understood? So you have put d theta by dx at x equal to 0 equal to minus theta naught m tan into this equation, that is Fourier's equation. You are going to get this. You know KAC m represents square root of HP K times AC theta naught tan hyperbolic ml. The equation 11 gives a heat transfer rate for an insulated. Next, case number 3. Okay, fin losing heat at its tip by convection. Okay. So suppose the fin is losing heat at its tip by convection. Okay. Now this is a temperature profile. Okay, has been shown in 2.5b. And boundary conditions we are going to apply is at x equal to 0, theta will be theta naught as usual. At x equal to L, heat conducted through AC will be equal to heat convected through AC. Okay, whatever heat that has been entering this tip, same heat will be leaving through convection. That is a second boundary condition. at x equal to L. We will apply to these two boundary condition to equation number 3. Let us try to find the constant C1 and C2. Okay, first boundary condition, when you apply, you are going to get theta will be theta naught as usual. C1 cos hyperbolic M0, this you know, okay, already we have done for two things. So C1 will be theta naught. When you apply second boundary condition, what is the heat conducted through cross section area AC at x equal to L? That is the second. This is the second boundary condition. If you see here, minus heat conducted equation is minus ka d theta by dx. Heat convected is ha theta, and the cross section area is AC. Okay, because what the heat transferring area is cross section area. AC gets cancelled. Remaining is minus k times d theta by dx at x equal to L, h into theta at x equal to L. Now, okay, first we have substituted C1 in equation number 3, that is theta will be C1 is theta naught cos hyperbolic mx plus C2 sin hyperbolic mx. Next we will use the second boundary condition. Okay, minus k I have written as it is. Either I am using this equation. Okay, please look into this. I am using this equation. Minus k I have written as it is. AC already cancelled. D theta by dx. Okay, I am going to differentiate this equation with respect to x, and I have put here. So if you differentiate this d theta by dx, it will be theta naught m into sine hyperbolic m into L, because we have taken at x equal to L. No, see here the boundary condition, we have taken x equal to L and d theta by dx we want. Okay, so minus k I have written as it is. AC has already cancelled. D theta by dx at x equal to L. You differentiate this equation with respect to x and put for x equal to L. That's all I have done here. So theta naught m, differentiation of cos is sine hyperbolic m into L plus C2 I written as it is. Again, differentiation of sine hyperbolic mx is m cos hyperbolic m into x. Instead of x, I am going to put L because we have taken x equal to L. That will be equal to h into theta. What is theta? Theta naught cos hyperbolic m into x. Instead of x, we are going to put L because x is equal to L plus C2 sine hyperbolic m into L. Okay, and this has been simplified for C2. Okay. So what I have done is, okay, here C2 m cos hyperbolic ml is there. No, I have taken this to the right hand side. Okay, so that C2 is common. Can you see here? This is C2 m cos hyperbolic ml with minus k. When it goes to the right hand side, it will become plus k. So plus km, that is nothing but mk. Okay, km or mk, same value, cos hyperbolic ml. Okay, and plus okay, so here so I have simplified for theta naught C2, which will be minus theta naught, okay, km sin hyperbolic m plus h times cos hyperbolic m divided by mk cos hyperbolic m plus h times sine hyperbolic ml, which is equal to minus theta naught. Okay, what I have done is I have divided this equation with h cos hyperbolic ml. It will be 1 plus mk by h tan hyperbolic ml. Okay, here also I am dividing by h cos hyperbolic ml. Okay, so it is mk by h. Okay, this cos hyperbolic ml gets cancelled, plus h by mk sine by cos. Again, it will be tan hyperbolic ml. Okay. So this equation you understood, no? What we have done is, okay, C2m cos hyperbolic ml minus k C2 sin hyperbolic ml, okay? Just this C2m cos hyperbolic ml k, you take it to the right hand side, this, and this will be h into C2 sin hyperbolic ml, okay? That is what, C2 is common, and here this one you take it to the left hand side, it will become minus this theta naught of this, okay? And get the value for theta C2, that's all. Okay, just mathematics simplification you have to do. So once you got C2, this you understood, no? Okay, numerator and denominator I have divided by h cos hyperbolic ml. Okay, illi first term alli km by h athwa mk by h, sine by cos is tan. That is what I have written here. H cos hyperbolic by h cos is 1. Okay, that is 1. 1 plus this. And here also divided by h cos hyperbolic ml on, okay. So you are going to get this. Okay. And substitute the value of C1 and C2 in equation 3, you are going to get this equation. This you know. So theta is equal to C1 theta naught cos hyperbolic mx minus of this C2 of this value into sine hyperbolic mx. So you have got the temperature distribution equation along the length of the fin. For a fin losing heat at its tip by convection, and determine the heat transfer rate, as usual Q is equal to minus K times AC d theta by dx at x equal to 0. So what you have to do is you have to differentiate equation number 12. Okay, differentiate this equation number 12 with respect to x. Okay, and put x equal to 0. So that is what you are going to get here. Differentiate 12. You are going to get theta naught as usual m into sine hyperbolic mx, m into sine hyperbolic m into x equal to 0 minus this constant remains same, okay, and you have to differentiate sine hyperbolic mx, that will be m cos hyperbolic mx, m cos hyperbolic m 0, okay. So this will be 0 because sine hyperbolic of 0 is 0, this will be 1, cos hyperbolic m into 0 is 1. So you have got d theta by dx, just put this value equation for 15 in equation 14, you are going to obtain the heat transfer rate. Okay. I have told you KACM, you can, because m is equal to what, square root of HB by K times AC. So you can write square root of KAC into square root of KAC. So 1 square root is square root of k times AC, denominator also square root of KAC gets cancels. What you are going to get, square root of HP k times AC theta naught of this. See, this equation if you are using to find the heat transfer rate, it is little bit complicated. So in practice, what we are going to use is, okay, we are going to use a heat transfer for a insulated end, okay, insulated fin heat transfer rate formula will be used, but with corrected length, okay, that is LC instead of L we are going to use, then you can obtain the heat transfer rate, okay, with corrected length. For rectangular fins, LC is given by L plus thickness divided by 2, where T is the thickness of the fin. If it is a cylindrical fins, okay, L plus R by 2, okay, R represents radius of the fin. Okay, remember this corrected length, and once you know this corrected length, you can use the heat transfer for insulated fin. That formula can be used. What is that formula? Square root of HP KAC theta naught tan hyperbolic ml. So L, instead of L, we are going to use LC. Tan hyperbolic ml is there, no? For L, we are going to use LC, that's all. So last case, fin of finite length with specified temperature at its end. Okay, this is a left hand side, we have taken temperature to be as T1, and right hand side the temperature is T2. H and TA represents heat transfer coefficient and ambient temperature at the surrounding fluid. L is the length of the fin. This is the temperature profile I have shown you. Okay, we'll try to obtain the equation for temperature distribution and heat transfer rate. Okay. So same at x equal to 0, what is theta here? at x equal to 0, theta will be what? Theta 1. Okay, that is t1 minus ta. Okay, if you see here, t minus tl. So at x equal to 0, that is at x equal to 0, t will be t1. At x equal to l, t will be t2. Okay, t1 minus ta, t2 minus t, at x equal to 0, at x equal to l. So we are going to apply the first boundary condition to equation number 3. We are going to get c1 equal to theta 1, because what is theta? Theta is equal to c1 cos hyperbolic mx plus c2 sin hyperbolic mx. So if you put x equal to 0, that right hand side is going to get cancelled, then c1 will be theta 1 as usual. Next, we are going to use the second boundary condition. Okay, that is for equation number 3. Equation number 3, theta will become theta 2. Theta will become, okay, theta 2. C1 cos hyperbolic m into x, k, we have put x equal to l. Plus C2 sin hyperbolic m into x, instead of x, we have put l. Okay, this is nothing but equation 3. Only thing is, we have used second boundary condition, that is at x equal to l, for x we have put l, theta will be theta 2. That is what here, theta will be theta 2, c1 cos hyperbolic mx plus c2 sin hyperbolic mx. Next, rest of the things are everything mathematics, simplification. Okay, for c1 I have put theta 1, understood? Okay, c1, can you see here, c1 I have put theta 1 and I have found what is c2, that is this equation. Now you have got c1 and c2, I have put it in equation number 3, that is theta equal to theta 1 cos hyperbolic mx, what is c2, this sin hyperbolic mx. Now simplify for theta. Okay, this is everything is mathematics. Okay, I have taken sin hyperbolic ml and as a LCM, and I have simplified this, you have got this equation, theta is equal to this. This equation represents temperature distribution along the length of the fin. And next one is heat transfer rate, which is given by, see, okay, I am going to integrate from 0 to L, okay, h into p dx, this is surface area of the fin, temperature T at any point minus TA. I am going to use this, that will be hp dx d theta. Okay, that is nothing but HP HP theta into dx. Dx I have taken right hand side. Okay, HP theta dx. Okay, HP can be taken outside because they are constants, 0 to L. For theta, I have used this equation. Theta will be this. Okay, theta 1 sin hyperbolic m into, okay, use this equation for theta into dx, and you are going, integrated, what you are going to get, this, integrate this. Okay, the sin hyperbolic ml is also a constant, I can take it outside because m is constant. M is nothing but what, square root of hp by k times ac, all are constants. H is constant, perimeter is constant, k is constant, cross section area is constant, so m is constant, and again length is constant, you can take it outside the integration. If you integrate this, okay, what you are going to get, minus, because minus x is there, minus theta 1, integration of sine is cos hyperbolic m into, divided by m, and again plus theta 2, integration of sine is cos hyperbolic m is divided by m from 0 to L. So apply these two conditions, 0 to L, okay, so HP by sin hyperbolic m minus theta 1 by m. Okay, first L for x, you are going to put L, it will become 1, because L minus L is 0, that will become 1, minus L x, instead of x, you are going to put 0. So that will become cos hyperbolic m. Okay, theta 1 by m, I have taken outside. Okay, of this, again theta 2 by m outside. Okay, I am going to apply these two conditions, that is L and 0, 0 and L. Cos hyperbolic ml, cos hyperbolic ml minus, because x, we can put L, minus cos hyperbolic m into 0, it will become 1. Okay, it's as simplified this. Okay, HP sign up M times. Okay, M is there now on both the sides. You can take, okay, here also M, here also M. You can take it outside. Then, okay, you take it minus inside. It will become minus 1 plus cos hyperbolic ML. That will nothing but cos hyperbolic ML minus 1. Here also cos hyperbolic ML minus 1 is there. You can take it outside and this will become theta 1 plus theta 2 into cos hyperbolic ML minus 1. So, this equation represents heat transfer for a fin with specified temperature at its ends. Right. So, I am coming to the MCQ. For effective working of fins, the thickness of the fin should be large, small. Thickness of fin does not affect unpredictable. It should be small. The thickness of the fin should be small. Next, a fin of uniform cross-section area and perimeter P has a base temperature and it is exposed to fluid having time over the temperature distribution. This is, they have given the formula, no? Okay. Already we have derived the formula. Okay. T minus T infinity equals C1. That is actually theta will be, now we have written theta will be C1 e power mx plus C2 e power minus m. That, okay, this equation is the actual equation. Temperature distribution in the fin. Theta will be C1 e power mx plus C2 e power minus mx. We have written A and B. Here they have given C1 and C2. Okay. Thank you.